Hi, believers. Hi, Israel. Not very good light, huh? Let's see what I can do. So I just went into a big rant on my tribe. You know what the Lord did? He shut the video off. You know why? Because I was being an ornery ass Benjamite. I'm not going to defend my tribe. I'm not going to defend myself. I thought I would, because I get very defensive of my tribe. I get defensive of my people, Israel. So I'm worn out now. He shut the phone off. I was all full of the Spirit. I was full of myself. Also, let me see if I can sit still long enough for this camera to focus on me. Stupid, huh? In and out and in and out. What? Really? That sucks. It sucks. I guess I'm not supposed to do this one. I'm just going to make up one point and then close out, take a walk. I got to stop. So all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, the Heavenly Father, the only begotten Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let me drink some cold coffee, settle myself. So I was going to go into my tribe, my two tribes. You can't be of two tribes, J.D. Nijah. Heavenly Father, bless this message. Give me some patience, some strength, some heart, some love, some charity, some generosity. Amen. Okay, so what I was explaining in the last video that got cut off was if you know the Bible at all, especially the Old Testament, the Hebrew part, the Israelite part, you would never say something so ignorant as you can't be two tribes, J.D. Nijah. We know. I know. I'm intricately linked to the tribe of Judah, even though I'm Benjamin. Why is that, people? Does anybody know? Let's just break it down. Simple as sauce. Who was born in Bethlehem? Jay Hall? I'm not gonna be mean. Who was born in Jerusalem, people? In Bethlehem Ephratah. Our Savior, Jesus Christ, was born in Bethlehem. What tribe was he from? GMS, since you guys are such experts on your tribe. Yep, he was Judah, right? Who else was born in Bethlehem Ephratah? Believers, do we know? The truck went by has wolf pup on it. You might be able to see it. Wolf pup. Benjamin's the wolf. He ravens like a wolf. Benjamin was born in Bethlehem. Do you understand, Jay Hall, why I say I'm of Benjamin of Judah? You don't get it? Dude. Believers. I remember myself being in the city. Yeah. I remember myself. I was a servant. Kind of the same guy I am now, right? I'm a servant. I just said in the last video, I'm just going to read one scripture and then I'm going to close out and take a walk. It's, wearying to be Israel and try and teach. It really is. It's not. This guy has been listening to me for over a year. He doesn't understand yet. He can't be Benjamin. He can't be Judah. He's not black. He's blah, blah. You know why Benjamin is so courageous and tough? I said it in the last video, because we are stuck in the middle with you, priests to the left of me, Judites to the left, here I am, stuck in the middle with you. How does Benjamin know grace? How does he know his five senses are working? Because he saw it all. He could sniff it out. He was feeling the kings. He was feeling the priests. We were doing it all. We were watching the gates. We were opening the doors. We were singing. We were worshiping. We were playing all the games between the priests and the kings. And I don't need scripture to tell me that, bro. But I have it. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. Sorry. I'm just going to read one scripture and then I'm going to go. I'm going to point this out to you. Jay Hall, I'm not going to be mean to you, dude. I could really be mean to you. I love you, brother. It's all right. Just stay in your lane, man. Get out of my way. I'm not fucking around with any of these guys. Do you think I'm scared? Come on, sir. Come on, sir. Let's go to, let's do this first, and then if I have time, I'll go back. I've said it over and over again. It's in Genesis. Benjamin is known for his courage. 49:27. The smallest of the tribes. The least of Bethlehem Ephrata. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? The least of the tribes. You will come out of the least of them, of Bethlehem Ephrata. I'm part of the family, man. Ming. So we're in Ezra, and then I'll close out. I'm not gonna belabor the point. I could speak all day on the reason Benjamin is of Judah. First of all, we're of the southern kingdom. The Levites, the Benjamites, and the Judites were all together. We were the ones that stayed home when the other 10 goofball tribes ran off and started dancing around in the groves up there in Samaria. We stayed home. All right, here we go. This is good enough. If you don't get it, you don't get it. But I can only credential myself so long before I snap. King Cyrus's proclamation. What do I say? I'm a Benjamin of Judah. Why? Because of Bethlehem Ephrata. Benjamin was born, same place where our Lord was born. Do you think I'm not claiming that? Ezra 1:1, King Cyrus's proclamation. Let me read it as best I can. Now, in the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, that the word of the Lord by the mouth of Jeremiah the prophet might be fulfilled. Who's Jeremiah? He's a Benjamite. This is all family stuff, people. You churchies, if you don't have to listen if you don't want to. Just know that I'm telling you the truth. I'm telling you why J. Hall doesn't get it. He doesn't know the Bible well enough. He wouldn't know the Bible if it fell on his foot. By the mouth, why is Jeremiah prophesying? Because he's a Benjamite. That's what we do. We're trying to warn people, all right? Okay, the word of the Lord by the mouth of Jeremiah might be fulfilled. The Lord stirred up the spirit of Cyrus, king of Persia, that he made a proclamation throughout all his kingdom and put it also in writing, saying, what did he say? What did he write? Thus said Cyrus, king of Persia, the Lord God of heaven has given me all the kingdoms of the earth, and he has charged me to build him a house at Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Where's the temple, people? Jerusalem. Bethlehem Ephrata. City of David. You ever heard of it? City of David. Who is there among you of all his people? Who is there among you of all his people? His God be with you, and let him go up to Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Get it? Are you with me so far? Go build me a house. I'm proclaiming it. Cyrus, king of Persia. I'm proclaiming it. The Lord, your God, the power, the Yahweh Vaveh that I know has the power. I'm giving you a proclamation to go. What, is there anyone there to go do it? Who? Build the house of the Lord God of Israel. He is the God, in parentheses. He is the God. He is that Yahweh Vaveh, Jehal, Ahaya, Yahweh, the Adonai. You can't say it because you don't have the right. Just keep saying Ahaya. That's your God. And whosoever remains in any place where he sojourn, let the men of his place help him with the silver and with the gold and with the goods and with the beasts, besides the freewill offering for the house of God that is in Jerusalem. What's he saying? Anybody that can get with these guys, get with them. Anybody that has resource, give it. Verse 5, captives return to Jerusalem. Who are these people that went home? Jay Hall. Let me give you a clue. Let me give you a little hint. Sorry, believers. That's why I don't go on the comment boards. That's why I can't. He's the reason why I don't go to the comment boards. Because he tries to correct me. And he knows not. Verse 5, Ezra 1:1. Then rose up the chief of the fathers of Judah and Benjamin. Then rose up the chief of the fathers of Judah and Benjamin, and the priests and the Levites, with all of them whose spirit God had raised to go up to build the house of the Lord, which is in Jerusalem. Why am I here every day doing this, people? Because I'm of Benjamin, of Judah, of the priests, of the Levites. How many times am I going to have to say it? Of the porters, of the singers, of the servants, of the prophets. And all they that were about them strengthened their hands with vessels of silver, gold, and goods, and with beasts and with precious things, besides all that was willingly offered. What are you supposed to be doing, Jay Hall? You're supposed to be standing in the shadows going, he's right. I believe him. I stand behind my brother. Empower me, not... You know what happens right after this, right? Do you know what happens after this? The other people wanted to come help out. But... they didn't get it. Gifts for the temple. And some of these chiefs of the fathers, this is Ezra 2:68. Let me just read this and then we'll close out so that you get a taste for it. Can you sniff out the truth? Can you see? Do you understand? Listen. Numbers of people and livestock. The whole congregation together was 42,303. Besides their servants and their maids, in whom there were 7,337, and there were among them 200 singing men and singing women. And the horses were 700, and the mules, and the camels, And they brought gifts. And some of the chiefs of the fathers, when they came to the house of the Lord, which is at Jerusalem, offered freely for the house of God to set up in his place. They gave after their ability under the treasure of the work 80,000 drams of gold, 5,000 pounds of silver, and 100 priests' garments. So the priests, So the priests and the Levites and some of the people and the singers and the porters and the Nethinims dwelt in their cities and all Israel in their cities. That's us. That's Judah, Benjamin. That's the captives that came back from Babylon. Jay Hall, do you know your Bible at all? Do you know anything about Judah? That's the story, bro. That's why I'm mad at these black Hebrew Israelites. They don't even know their own brother's name is not Benjaminite. They're not Judah. They're not Israel. You say I'm not Israel? Tell me something I don't know. Sorry, believers. That's why I don't go on the comment boards. I'm trying to move forward with this Bible teaching. Let's go to Jeremiah 20 real quick. This should be easy. Jeremiah is a Benjamite. Jeremiah 20 and 2. What's it say? Then Pashur smote Jeremiah the prophet and put him in the stocks that were in the high gate of Benjamin, which was by the house of the Lord. What's the high gate of Benjamin? Let me read it again. Then Pashur smote Jeremiah the prophet and put him in the stocks that were in the high gate of Benjamin, which was by the house of the Lord. Where's the gate of Benjamin? By the high gate. You don't know where the high gate is, Jay Hall. You're in the church of the church. You're in the congregation of the innocent. Don't be stepping over in this area. It's not a good place for you to be stepping, bro. Because you don't know. Jeremiah, let's go to Jeremiah again. Then I'll close out. That's why the arguing with people is too much for me. I'm not here to argue. I've heard enough. I've seen enough. I know enough. Not to be arrogant. I'm saying be blessed. Listen, if you have any questions, get your Bible out. You tell me. I don't think you can. You can't be of two tribes, J.D. Nisha. Fucking idiot. Jeremiah 37:13. And then I'll apologize. I'm sorry, believers, but like I said, that's why I don't go to the comment boards. I'm not here to listen. I listen to everything. I listen to everyone, and then I report back to you. That's what I do. What's real and what's not. What's true and what's false. Moreover, Jeremiah said unto King Zedekiah, what have I offended against thee or against thy servants or against the people that ye have put me in prison? Where are now your prophets which prophesied unto you, saying, the king of Babylon? Where are your prophets? The Lord just wanted me to throw that one out there. Down here. Jeremiah imprisoned, and it came to pass when the army of the Chaldeans was broken up from Jerusalem for fear of Pharaoh's army. Then Jeremiah went forth out of Jerusalem to go into the land of Benjamin to separate himself thence in the midst of the people. What am I? I'm separate. Holy. And when he was in the gate of Benjamin, a captain of the ward was there whose name was Arijah, the son of Shelemiah, the son of Hananiah. And he took Jeremiah the prophet, saying, "Thou fallest away to the Chaldeans?" Then Jeremiah said, "That's false. I will not fall away to the Chaldeans." But he hearkened not to him. So Arijah took Jeremiah and brought him to the princes. Therefore the princes were wroth with Jeremiah and smote him and put him in prison in the house of Jonathan, the scribe, for he had made that the prison. When Jeremiah had entered into the dungeon and into the cabins, and Jeremiah had remained there many days. You can put me in prison. You can stand against me. You can say I'm not speaking truth. You can do all that stuff to me. You know what? It doesn't. Really? All it does is irritate me and irritate my Lord. JD Niger, word of truth. Sorry, believer. Sorry. I want to apologize for my short temper. Don't you judge. Don't you judge my short temper. Because these scars I carry across my heart, that pain I must remember, it's real. JD Niger, I'm out. Love you, Israel. Love you, believers. Till the next one.